Hey, Byron here. Just want to spend a few minutes with you on handling criticism. When we step into the role of leadership, whether it be a manager or a supervisor, leading a group, CEO, maybe a teacher, even a parent, we take on that role of leadership, we will receive criticism. Most of the times it's around our decisions, but many times we take it personally. So here are some things that can help you with that kind of criticism. Do note that some criticism is direct and straightforward, and some criticism is just perceived. We feel like we're being criticized when we're actually not. Either way, it does affect how we lead, and it affects how we make decisions. And I want to help you be able to stand in your authority of your leadership. Stand behind your decisions or make whatever adjustments, regardless of the criticism. So, as I was reading a blog one day, I ran across these steps to handling criticism and really honed them in and made them a part of my coaching practice. And so, several of my clients now have really benefited from these three steps, felt like they've helped them be more effective as leaders. So here are the steps. The first step is what's not true and needs to be dismissed. Really, it's as simple as that. Stand in your authority, stand behind your decision. It's not true what they're criticizing you about, and just let it go. Move on, because you are the one in authority. The second one's similar but a little bit different. What's not true but needs to be addressed. And we want to be careful with this particular step because we don't want to come across as defensive. When we come across as defensive, then it does make us look like we did not make a good decision. So it goes a little bit like this. You note the criticism and say, I can see where you would see it that way or how it might look this way to you. So I'll look at a different way of presenting it. It doesn't change the fact that my decision was correct. Notice the difference there. There's no defense in why you made the decision you made. It's just, oh, well, I could approach that differently. Then the third step is what might be true and you would need to own and will help you grow. Here takes some vulnerability. You need to be able to hold yourself accountable and admit, oh yeah, that might not have been a very good decision, but I can learn from this. Help me, ask for help, and you'd be surprised how much harder people under you would work for you when they see that you're willing to own either a bad decision or a mistake. So that helps you grow. Also, doesn't shake the fact that you're still the leader. Doesn't take away your authority when you own those things. And so those three steps, what's not true needs to be dismissed, what's not true needs to be addressed, and what might be true and could be worked on. So many of my clients have put these steps into practice and have found them very, very valuable. If you want any help from me, just contact me, set up a free call. I'd love to work with you. Thanks.